Hello everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share some summer hairstyles. These are all styles that I love to wear in the summer, so I really hope you enjoy today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell, and let me know in the comments which of the three hairstyles is your favorite, and let's get started. To start this hairstyle, I'm going to first divide out a section of hair at my crown. Then I'm going to take an elastic band and tie off the section. Now I'm going to take an alligator clip and clip this out of the way to use later. Now I'm going to divide out a new section of hair right underneath the top section, and I'm going to tie the hair together using another elastic band right underneath the first elastic. Then I'm going to let down the first ponytail that I previously clipped up, and holding the top section, I'm going to divide off a small piece of hair on the left side of the ponytail and drop it down next to the bottom ponytail. Then I'm going to divide off a small section of hair on the left side of the second ponytail and bring it upwards, holding it in my left hand. So now I'm going to divide off another piece from the top ponytail and drop it down so it's on the right side of the piece that I previously divided off. Next, I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from the bottom ponytail and bring it up between the top ponytail, and I'm going to hold it in my left hand. Then I'm taking a small section from the top ponytail and dropping it down in between the sections of the bottom ponytail. Then I'm going to take a small section from the bottom ponytail and bring it up between the top ponytail and hold it in my left hand. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, alternating small sections of hair between the top and bottom ponytails, keeping the sections from the bottom ponytail in my left hand, while dropping down the hair from the top ponytail, so the pieces alternate between the top ponytail and the bottom ponytail. And then once the two ponytails are divided up into small alternating sections, I'm going to take the hair I was holding in my left hand, so the hair from the second ponytail, and I'm going to clip this out of the way to use for the next ponytail section. So now I'm going to divide out a new section of hair from behind my ears, combine it with the hair divided out from the first ponytail, the hair that was dropped straight down, and tie it all together using an elastic band. Now I'm going to let down the hair that was clipped away and go back over this first loop that I created and pull on the edges to make the section a lot fuller. And then I'm going to repeat those same steps with the two new sections of hair. So now I have two new ponytail sections, and I'm dividing each ponytail into smaller sections, and I'm alternating between the top ponytail and the bottom ponytail, and I want to drop down the hair from the bottom ponytail while holding the hair from the second ponytail in my left hand. So I'm taking a piece from the top, dropping it down, taking a piece from the bottom ponytail and holding it up, then taking a piece from the top ponytail, dropping it down, taking a piece from the bottom ponytail and holding it up in my left hand. And I'm just going to work my way through both ponytail sections until all of the hair is divided up. Then I'm going to clip away the hair from the bottom ponytail, pick up the rest of the hair from my head and tie it all together with the hair from the top ponytail to create a new section of the hairstyle. Then I'm going to let down the hair that was clipped away, and I'm going to go back over this second section of hair that I created, and I'm going to carefully pull on the edges, and this will make this puffed section a little bit puffier and more full, and it will be a little bit easier to see. And I'm just going to repeat those steps two more times, creating two more sections of the braid. So the concept is similar to a pull-through braid, but instead of using two large sections, you're creating and working with smaller pieces of hair from each ponytail section. So the sections are alternating between the top ponytail and the bottom ponytail, going in and out of each other. And when doing this hairstyle, you can create as many sections of the braid as you'd like. I went ahead and did four sections based on the length of my hair. So you can do more sections or less, depending on the style that you want to end up with or depending on the length of your hair. But then once I've finished all of the sections, I'm just going to spray the style with hairspray and smooth down any flyaways. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to start by picking up a section of hair at the center of my forehead And I'm going to divide this into three pieces to begin my braid. I'm going to begin a French braid, so I'm going to cross the right strand over the middle and then cross the left strand over the middle. And after the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to cross the left side over the middle, pick up a new section and cross it over and add it into the middle strand. Then I'm going to cross the right strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it over and into the middle strand. And now I'm going to begin waterfalling the side strands. So I'm going to drop down the right strand, pick up a new section from right behind it, and cross it over the middle strand in place of the dropped piece. Then I'm going to drop down the left strand, pick up a new section from right behind it, and cross it over and into the middle strand in its place. So once more, I'm going to drop down the right strand, pick up a new section of hair right behind the dropped piece, and cross it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. Then I'm going to drop down the left strand, pick up a new section and cross it over the middle strand in place of the dropped piece. Then I'm going to drop down the left strand, pick up a new section of hair and cross it over the middle strand in place of the dropped piece. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, continuing the braid along the top of my head, working my way down the back of my head towards the nape of my neck. So I'm always dropping down the side strand and then picking up a new piece next to the braid, crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. And I'm just going to alternate between the left side and the right side, working my way down the back of my head until the braid reaches the nape of my neck. Once the braid reaches my neck, I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the right side of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to pick up a section of hair on the right side of my head, and I'm going to divide this section into three pieces for my Dutch braid. I'm going to cross the left strand under the middle, and then cross the right strand under the middle. Then I'm going to cross the left strand under the middle, pick up the first waterfall piece from the first braid, and cross it underneath the middle strand. Then I'm going to cross the right strand under the middle, pick up a new section of hair from the right side of my head, and cross it under into the middle strand as well. Then I'm going to cross the left strand under the middle. Then I'm going to pick up the next waterfall piece and cross it under the middle strand. Then I'm going to cross the right strand under the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under, adding it into the braid. And I'm going to continue this Dutch braid style braid, adding in the waterfall strands one by one on the left side of the braid, while also bringing in new sections of hair to the right side of my head along the hairline, until all of the hair on this side of my head is brought into the braid. So I'm just working along the hairline down towards the nape of my neck. And once the braid reaches the nape of my neck, I'm going to tie off the bottom of the braid using a clear elastic band. Now I'm going to repeat those same steps and create a second braid with the hair on the left side of my head. Since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm always crossing the side strands underneath the middle strand. This will make the braid sit out on top of my head. And I'm adding in the waterfall pieces into the right side of the braid. And from along the hairline on the left side of my head, I'm going to be bringing in new sections of hair so that all of this hair on this side of my head is brought into the braid, so that all of the hair on this side of my head is incorporated into the braid. And I'm just working my way along the hairline down towards the nape of my neck. And then once the braid reaches my neck, I'm going to tie off the end of the braid with another clear elastic band. And now I'm just going to go back over both of the braids, and I'm going to pull on the edges just to pull them out a little bit. This will make them look a little bit bigger. And then I'm going to wrap a small section of hair around each elastic and secure the wrapped hair underneath using a bobby pin. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to divide out a small section of hair at the back of my head. This is going to be my wrapping piece. So I'm going to divide out another section on the right side, and this is going to be my right side section. So with my wrapping piece, I'm just going to wrap this clockwise around the right section of hair, bringing it back to the left side of the section. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair on the left side of my head, and this is going to be my left side section. I'm going to take my wrapping piece now and wrap this counterclockwise around the left section so it's back between the two sections again. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair and add it into the right section. Then I'm going to take my wrapping piece and wrap it clockwise around the right section. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from the left side of my head and add it into the left section. Then I'm going to take my wrapping piece and wrap it counterclockwise around the left side section. And now I'm going to add a new section of hair into my right section and wrap it clockwise with the wrapping piece. So the wrapping piece always ends up right in the middle of my left and my right section. Then I'm going to add a new section of hair from the left side of my head into the left section. And then wrap it counterclockwise with the wrapping piece so it ends up back in the middle. So the left and right sections are always staying in the same place, and the wrapping piece is always in between the two sections. And I'm going to bring in a new section of hair and pair it into each side section before wrapping it with the middle wrapping piece. So it's forming an infinity symbol around the two sections with the wrapping piece. So as you're braiding, you just want to make sure to keep the wrapping piece really tight around the two sections to avoid getting any gaps in the braid. And if the wrapping piece starts to feel too thin or too short, you can pick up a new section from the back of the head and add it into the wrapping piece. So I'm just going to repeat those steps, continuing the braid, bringing in new sections of hair from both sides of my head until they reach about the top of my ears so that the style will end up being a half-up style. So once I've done a few stitches of the braid and brought in hair from above my ears, I'm going to reverse the braid and start taking small sections out instead of adding them in. So I'm going to divide off a small piece of hair from the right side. Then I'm going to wrap the section with the wrapping piece, working in the same direction as before. Then I'm going to divide off a small piece from the left section and then wrap the left section counterclockwise with the wrapping piece. Then I'm going to take a small section from the right side and divide it out, and then wrap it with the wrapping piece in the same direction as before. Then I'm going to divide off another section from the left side, and then wrap that section with the wrapping piece like I had been doing before. So I'm going to divide off a small piece of hair from the right side, then I'm going to wrap the section with the wrapping piece, working in the same direction as before. Then I'm going to divide off a small piece from the left section and then wrap the left section counterclockwise with the wrapping piece. Then I'm going to take a small section from the right side and divide it out and then wrap it with the wrapping piece in the same direction as before. Then I'm going to divide off another section from the left side and then wrap that section with the wrapping piece like I had been doing before. And I'm just going to be repeating those steps, taking out small pieces of hair from each side, continuing to wrap them in the same infinity pattern until the side sections become too small to split. And then I'm just going to take a clear elastic band and wrap it over the bottom of the braid to hold it in place. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. Make sure to let me know in the comments section which of the three hairstyles is your favorite and if you plan on trying them out. I really like knowing that my videos are helpful. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell in case you haven't already, then you'll never miss future videos. And I will see you next time.